Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Somebody ought to give God a big, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Felt something other than me today. Amen. Come on, somebody tell God thank you. Amen. Glory to God. We certainly want to thank God for this great devotional team and this great choir. Amen. For our praise and worship service. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Amen. Thank God for that. He's one. Amen. Being such a great, powerful, amen, devotional service. Amen. Glory to God. You may be seated. Amen. Through the thoughts we got a little bit, Father. Amen. Amen. We honor our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Come on. Amen. 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 Can we give honor to our great pastor and apostle Ronnie Stoker Jr.? Amen. Praise the Lord. Woo! gonna read, amen. Start reading at the 10th verse of the 21st chapter of St. John. This may not be a shouting message, but it could be a deliverance message. Amen. When you get to say amen, stand to your feet, amen, as we read the word of God. 21st chapter of St. John, I will commence reading at the 15th verse. So when they had had dinner, supper, Jesus said unto Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than these? He said unto him, Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, Feed my lamb. He said unto him again the second time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? He said unto him, Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, Feed my sheep. He said unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, Lovest thou me? And he said unto him, Lord, I knoweth all things. I knoweth that I love thee. Jesus said unto him, Feed my sheep. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, when thou were young, thou girded thyself and walked whither thou wouldest. But when thou shalt be old, thou shalt stretch forth thy hand, and another shall gird thee and carry thee whither thou wouldest not. This spake he, signifying by what death he should glorify God. And when he had spoken this, he said unto him, Follow me. I want you to underline, Follow me. Then Peter, turning about, seeing the disciples whom Jesus loved following, which also leaned on his breath at supper, and said, Lord, which he had betrayed thee, which is he that betrayed thee? Peter seeing him, said to Jesus, Lord, and what shall this man do? Underline, and what shall this man do? Jesus said unto him, If I will he tarry till I come, what is that to thee? Follow thou me. Then went this saying abroad among the brethren that disciples should not die. Yet Jesus said not unto him, He shall not die, but if I will that he tarry till I come, what is that to thee? You may have your seat. Amen. From this text, from verse 21 and 22, I will give you a subject. Amen. Peter, seeing him, said to Jesus, Lord, and what shall this man do? And Jesus said unto him, If I will that he tarry till I come, what is that to thee? Follow thou me. Use this subject today. It's none of your business. It's none of your business. And for a subtopic, you just obey God. It's none of your business. You just obey God. I want you to know, amen, that this subject has nothing to do with your personal business, but everything to do with your obedience. A lot of time when you start mentioning about people's business, they'll tell you quick to stay out of my business. That's why I want you to know this has nothing to do with your personal business. Because if truth be told, some of our personal mess is so nasty and messy, I don't blame you for not wanting nobody to be in it. And we call ourselves Christian. And saints of God. I believe I heard the song, I don't know if it was the day of, because I have sometimes senior moments. But falling in love with Jesus all over again. Some of us that are confessing to be Christians and saved and sanctified, we need to fall in love with Jesus all over again. Amen. If you notice, Peter, he denied Jesus three times. So it was just fitting that Jesus would ask him three times, "Lovest thou me, Simon Peter, son of Jonah?" Peter replied, "Jesus, you know I love you." He said, "Well, feed my lamb, feed my sheep, feed my sheep." Peter had just come back from fishing. Sometimes when we decide that we don't want to do what Jesus has called us to do, we'll go back to doing what we used to do. And Peter and most of the disciples were fishermen by trade. After Jesus had shown himself to them on a couple of occasions, he even walked into a room where they were sitting. Showed himself, and Brother Thomas wasn't there at the time, so he was doubting whether they really saw him or not. So he said, "Unless I see him and I see the, amen, the hole in his side and the nail prints in his hand, I ain't gonna even believe it." But Jesus had to come along again and show Thomas that he had really risen from the dead. Then on another occasion, amen, this is when they was out fishing. The Bible said they fished all night long. Sometimes we go out and sail all night long trying to get a hit. And can't get nothing. We're trying to get that feeling we once got. Amen. Before we say we were saved and let Jesus come into our life. And we are standing all night long toiling and toiling and toiling and don't get nothing. But the Bible said, early that next morning, somebody saw a man walking on the seashore. And somebody looked out and recognized and said, "I believe that's the And Jesus asked them, "Have you caught anything? Stay out there long enough, you're going to catch something after a while. You're going to catch something that you don't want to catch." But they said, "No, we've been toiling all night long and ain't caught a thing." Nothing. See, when you go back to doing the things that you was doing before Jesus called you and appointed you, you don't fit in no more. You out there trying to dance and still do the spanky leg and it don't come out right. Out there trying to smoke don't even fit in out here no more. But Jesus told them, say, listen, if you've been out here all night long and haven't caught anything, listen, won't you take your net up and cast it on the right side? He said, you've been toiling all night long. But nevertheless, at your word, we're going to obey what you say. And the Bible says when they cast the net on the right side, say they got so many fish in it until it filled the net. And after filling the net, it didn't even break, amen. But after somebody recognized that that was Jesus that told them to cast it on the right side, Peter stepped out the boat. Y'all remember he stepped out the boat one time before and started walking on the water. Sometimes we can step out on God's word and do just what God say do. But soon as trials and tribulations and trouble come, we want to take our eyes off Jesus. And the Bible said Peter took his eyes off Jesus and he began to sink. That was on the other occasion, but this occasion he jumped out, got in the water, and ran to the shore. And Jesus had already prepared the fire.
Glory.
He had already prepared. He up there already cooking fish. While they out there trying to catch fish.
Glory.
He already cooking fish and got bread to go with. That's what God will do. They got through dying and Jesus decided to have a conversation with Peter. Pulled him off to himself. Because listen, when God give you a charge, brother, he give it to you.
Yes, Lord.
He don't give it to Evangelist Monica or Evangelist Cheyenne. He give you a charge. He instructs you what he wants you to do. He instructed Evangelist Warren what he wanted her to do. He has given her a charge. And all the time we have a tendency, amen, praise the Lord, we have a tendency, amen, of comparing our lives with others. You don't know what it took for Evangelist to get the anointing. Are you willing to stay up half of the night? Are you willing to fast and pray? Are you willing to give yourself a cry? Glory to God, you don't know what you're asking for. But Jesus pulled Peter aside and said, Peter, do you love me? This is what God is asking us today. Do you love me? Do you love me like you say you love me? Do you love me? It's one thing to say we love Jesus, but are you willing to serve and obey him? The worst sinner out in the street, amen, the worst drunk alcoholic out on the street, amen, cannot quote scriptures better than some of us in the house of God. So don't try to measure up your salvation by how many scriptures you've been quoting. But do you really love Jesus enough to serve him and to obey what he said to you? Stop looking at John and worrying about what John is doing. You obey God. You can't match up to Evangelist Warren because you don't have the call that she has. It ain't none of your business. Why God put, amen, Sister Christine, amen, as an usher. It ain't none of your business. It ain't none of your business why God raising up young people. Sister T, amen, to operate, amen, and to see over finances and the business in the church. It and do a great work for him. Glory to God. Some of you looking at the beam that's in your brother eye and can't see past that mole that's in your eye. Just look around. person that's behind you. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Stop worrying about John. If John stay here till I come back, not in your bed. He said, what about John? What's going to happen to John? Give John a charge.
Yes.
You're going to make John a great preacher. Is John going to feed your lamb too? Is John going to feed your sheep too? What about John? Is John going to die on the cross? I want to know, what about John? Jesus said, if John stay here till I come back, that ain't none of your business. But you follow me. Somebody say, yeah. In the end, when God gives you a charge, when God gives you a charge, then you don't like the answer that God gives you when you ask him a question. God, how much I got to suffer for this cross? How much I got to suffer for this gospel? You don't like the answer when God gives you the answer. He didn't like the answer, amen, that God gave him about John. So sometimes we in the church, we don't know what God said to Brother Scott. God done called Brother Scott off by himself and gave Brother Scott a charge. Told Brother Scott, I want you to be a deacon. Some of us sitting in here, been in here for a long time, and you haven't found your position yet. But you think Brother Scott is moving above you. So what you'll do, amen, you'll go and get a few members together. Y'all read the story. You'll go get a few members together, and you start talking. Peter went and got a few of the brethren and said, come here, guess what? Jesus told me that John wasn't going to die. Somebody tell God, thank you. You can be a preacher and lie in the church. Somebody say, yeah. Jesus didn't say John wasn't going to die. Oh, y'all missed that. Y'all missed that. Sometimes clicks. Sometimes won't come in and want to sow disco among the brethren, and they take the message out the wrong way. Jesus said, if I will that he tarry. How many know what tarry means?
All right.
Does that sound any kind of way that he ain't gonna die? He said, if I will that he wait right here till I come back, that ain't none of your business. Peter took me to run the wrong way with. Y'all stop taking stuff that you think you heard and you didn't hear it right and taking it out, running with it, and causing trouble in the church. What y'all say tarry mean? if I will that he wait here till I come back. What is that to you? So what Peter did in the 23rd verse, I want y'all to read that. Then went out this abroad among the brethren. How did it go out? Jesus was only talking to Peter. Peter must have took it out. It don't take but one canker. It don't take but one bit of cancer. It don't take but one little lump. It don't take but one little fox to get the hope of something and take it out wrong and destroy the whole body.
Shut up. That ain't none of your business. Shut up.
That disciple should not die. Tell me that ain't a lie. I don't care what your position is, you subject to lie. I don't care how high you think you are, you subject to do wrong. Somebody say, yeah. That's why we need it every day of our lives. We need to make men to walk with us. We need to talk with us. As we stand.
Oh, yes, God. Thank you, Lord.
Just another day. Spirit of God is saying yes. They come to this altar.